Let me get some music going. There's some wind going on. All right, so the morning after, when you guys wake up, it's a rather awkward setting in the Hoyden. You nonetheless you join together and you create a large pyre, and some of the bodies have already been dragged by a severely exhausted Kvanar who worked all night pulling bodies. And, at morning, you guys join together and you say your goodbyes, and you light a huge pyre with roughly 40 bodies in it, on it. And there's a large ceremony where everyone joins in, drinks a lot of mead, and say their prayers to the gods, as many fell in the battle for this day. But in the same time, they all died in battle, so people are, while they are not happy to see their loved ones and their families and friends being died in such a large mass, they're not shocked either, because they know that they will spend the rest of their life with the gods in Valhalla, as they died an honorable death. And even the Earl is on the pyre. While he was not loved by many, he did die a warrior's death.
I just, Lytar just kind of stands there with anybody who's also watching, and he just says, isn't it funny how people keep making the same mistakes over and over again?
Seems like no one thinks it's funny.
It wasn't a joke.
Everyone is heartbroken. They're like, they're my brothers. And the village seer, she plays a surprisingly, she don't care as much about this ceremony as you would think from a religious person. She just kind of initiated the ceremony and then she walked away to her hut. It's mostly the farmers who mourn their fallen comrades. The people from the village, while some of them are sad because their husband or brother died yesterday, they seem to be quite relieved, them as well.
Lytar's kind of happy that all this shit is over. Hopefully. Wondering if there's anybody here who's hearing what he's saying.
Nope.
And has something to add.
While you're pondering about life and death, would you please roll me a perception check?
Everyone, or just Lytar?
Lytar. He knew it was him. Okay, so as you are caught by the ceremony, thinking about life and death and what's the meaning of all this, you suddenly hear click, and you can feel that your legs are constrained by some kind of a metal apparatus.
I turn around.
You see Goldwick.
Oh! I got you!
Are you serious right now?
Yes.
First of all, you have no respect for the death to arrest somebody at a funeral.
What?
Second of all, I am the one who saved you all.
I'd like to interject. I just thought it was funny that you said people make the same mistake twice. However, you just did. Ha! I walk away.
Was me or this?
Child. I just. Actually, no. I'll go back and take my manacles. I like those.
You're gonna take them off him?
Yeah, I don't want to use them.
Because I just want to acknowledge the fact that if you're saying that I made the same mistake of getting shackled by an idiot twice, that's not really something that I have much control over.
Alright, so as the dwarf is about to release you from your manacles, you give him this polite comment. And I believe he sets you loose.
Yeah, take my manacles back.
Good. You're learning. I just continue watching the fire burn.
It's a rather weird smell in the air today. The scent of burning flesh is mixed with the high usage of mead and as well as some incense that is typically used in these kind of ceremonies. And the pure amount of burning bodies is making it quite hard to breathe, actually. There's something unnatural about the scent of a burning human, especially in this quantity.
Oh, I just conjure up a little wind around me to make it to give myself air to breathe.
And Quenar, you follow the seer.
Yeah.
She you see that she walks back into her little hut. Closes the door after.
Yeah, I'd like to follow her, unless she locks the door.
It's not locked. You can do whatever you like.
Yeah, I'm following her in.
When you open the door to her room, or to her hut, she says, "Ah, Hunter, what brings you here?
What worries you? Why didn't you stay at the pyre?"
"There is something unwary in the air. I can feel it. Something is disturbing these lands. I thought it was all connected to this earl, but I can see now that this was not it. There is something disrupting the force of nature. Something is very wrong. I know it."
"Is it in? Where is it coming from? From the forests or from the farms? Can I help you in some way?"
"Previously I thought it was connected to the earth, but now I realize that the power is all around us. I cannot describe it, but I know that something is wrong. And I have witnessed it both in my dreams and in my prayers that you and your followers are certainly gifted by the gods. You must find the source for all of this.
Why don't you say tell it everyone? Not like I am commanding them. They follow their own will.
It was the gods who brought you here, and so now I'm telling you.
Can you tell us where to search for it? I can only track what I know about.
The exact location, I know as little as you do. I know that something is wrong, and I have faith that the God have put their faith in you. Search your hearts and do your prayers and meditation, and I'm sure that the gods will show themselves to you.
Let us hope they do. Let us hope they do.
She says, before you go, there is an old relic that I thought I would never need. But in times like these, it seems like the sagas maybe weren't that crazy after all. And she hands you a leather pouch, and in it there are two rocks with the runes on them.
What do I do with this? I never learned to read runes.
She says that if ever in doubt, all you have to do is close your eyes and reach down to the pouch, and you will have your answer.
I shall remember that. Do you know, on the last day we were here before this whole fight started, I gave the Earl a knife. Do you know where he kept it? It might be connected to this whole thing.
She says that she seemed to remember him discarding some weapons down at by the altar. Maybe you can check there.
Thank you for your advice, and I go to the altar.
She nods and continues in some deep trance.
Can you make the sound a bit quieter in roll 20?
The music?
A bit off. Yeah.
Sure.
Okay. Yeah, I'm going to the altar.
And approaching the altar, you see that the knife from the day before indeed is laying there.
Someone, is it covered in blood?
It is covered in blood.
God damn. Well, I'm trying to clean it up first.
Yeah, some sort of a rag or something.
Alright, it's in this town. There isn't much snow around, right?
Yeah, there is snow.
Alright.
You managed to clean it up after a couple of minutes.
Yeah, okay.
Find some rag and some snow, and that ought to do it. Sigmar, predestination. Prestidigitation. God, that's an awkward word. Lilies. That's nice. See a halfling jumping around saying that it smells like lilies.
No, he's probably not gonna say anything. It's just the smell of burnt flesh. He kinda has had enough of it lately. So he's doing what he can to not be like touched by it.
Right. All right. Brucey, Roland, I guess.
Yes.
You're trying to study her wizard spells and trying to copy them?
Not even copy them, maybe just look at the book.
Alright.
And see, like, if I can find a spell that makes me think it involves light, see what it's about, see if I can learn anything. I'm trying to, like, derive alchemy ideas from magic, so I don't know if that's even possible, but that's what I'm thinking about.
You notice that under her invisibility spell, there's a note about it needing an eyelash.
Okay.
Encased in gum.
Of course.
The fuck were they smoking when they came up with this? But, let's see. Besides that, seems as if there are not many clues.
Okay.
And the notes themselves of the spells and their function.
Mm-hmm.
It is like you understand the language, kind of, but the way they're supposed to interact makes no sense to you, and it's all very confusing.
Okay.
An eyelash encased in gum. Right.
What is gum in this world? Is it just what I think it would be?
Yeah, I'm guessing that it's like, you know, the rubber.
An organic thing? Yeah. Plants. Okay, that's what I thought.
If it's not, I have no clue.
That Viking chewing gum.
Yeah. After a while, you guys see Cranor coming back from what seems to be the Seer's Hut.
Oh, so Roland is also there, right?
Yeah, I guess I'm outside the house because I'm sitting at that blue tree.
Oh yeah, that's right. So when you walked out of the Seer's Hut, you actually saw Roland sitting just outside, staring at the tree.
Yeah, I'm going to Roland and saying, it seems like they all didn't go crazy after for no reason. The seer says there is some dark force around. Do you know how we can find it?
I'm not sure, but I don't know that if we can chalk it all up to a dark force making him go mad. I'm sure there was some evil in there before that happened.
Oh no, he was evil, but the dark force remains after we killed him.
Wait, so this seer is saying that the Earl had someone control him, or something control it?
Did you go with us?
Mm-hmm. I guess he walked up to you.
Oh yeah,
it's fine.
Like, oh shit, where did you come from, Lidar?
Yeah.
Stop sneaking up on us!
Perception checks!
Say the guys who shackled me twice by.
No, maybe. There was no plural in that. That was all Goldwick by his own.
Did you, so you think there's something that's forcing him to have some sort of evil essence, or?
No, what she's saying is that there is some evil around, and she thought it came from an earl. But after we killed him, it still stays. So, the druid. You seem to like evil forces. Good luck finding it. Hope it kills you.
Fuck.
Mm.
Well, he almost killed me, so let's be frank here.
Shouldn't you be terrified?
No, because he's a pussy. Well, still.
So the Earl was controlled by dark force?
Stop trying to justify him. He was a dick.
I'm asking you. It's not.
We don't know. We are not druids. If you want to know, go find his body and research it.
Hey, stop being a dick. I'm just asking you a question. You just went to see a seer, and you're coming back with information. So I'm just asking for clarification.
Well, I just said that we don't know yet. And then you're asking, do we know? No, we don't.
Do you find that?
You have
dagger?
To understand that I don't know everything you know. I've only been here a day.
Do you find that dagger you put on him?
Yeah, he left it next to the bodies. No idea why he did it. And I'm giving Roland a dagger.
No. I don't want it.
Sure, I can carry it around for a while.
Alright, I don't want it.
Still, we need to start somewhere. Got any ideas?
Well, I might have an idea if you would just give me a little bit of information.
Which information do you need? It's not like I have much.
I'd like a short summary of the problem you're facing.
I don't know if I know much more than what he just said. There's something at work here that we're not quite sure about. There was a necromancer that we met a little while ago. We've been having strange dreams about the world ending. But beyond that, I don't know if there's anything really telling that I'd be able to share.
Well, thank you. That's already more information than I have before. There's a lot of words, but not a lot of context. So I think if you're affected by this, and I'm not, then there must be something going on with this town if you've been here for a while. Which means that it's a targeted attack.
Well,
it started in the town, so it's not like it should be about this town alone. The first time we had a dream, we were in Rakewell, and we met a necromancer in Rakewell. And then we had a dream.
Yeah, it was across the ocean, actually.
It never was in this city.
So it's following us, the town. Hey, Sigmar.
Alright, well, is there any reason why someone would do this to you?
Who does what?
Someone cursed the town. We need to find who did it if we want to leave. I didn't like meeting the first necromancer, and I don't want to meet another one.
You can't leave town?
Oh no, we can. It's just that there is some bad stuff happening around. At least this year so. Not related to the bodies.
Oh, besides dead bodies piling up.
Yeah, besides that.
Well, for maybe like a really simple first step, I could do just like a general detect evil spell and walk around the town and see if I notice anything's been desecrated or something like that. That's something really basic that I could do.
Maybe let's start at the altar?
Looking at Alta, yeah. Sigma probably doesn't need spell to tell you.
Yeah.
How far can you look with spell?
Not far. It's only like within 30 feet of me, but it lasts 10 minutes so I can walk around a bit.
How long do you need to cast?
It only takes them a second or two.
Oh, handy. Maybe keep it for later.
Sure.
So, what's the plan?
Oops, sorry. I was trying to click a unprepare. Don't touch me!
Did the seer ask you to do anything about it?
Well, yes, that's why I'm telling everyone. She asked us to find it and deal with it.
But she didn't give you any information how to find it.
She seemed to not know it herself. The gods are not very specific, as we have learned.
Yeah, no kidding.
So you guys spend a good 30 minutes discussing how you're gonna approach this problem. You hear how the farmers start to shout and say, "Oh, do you see who's coming over there?" And you hear one of the farmers get a bit agitated and weary as he rushes out of town. Roughly 5 minutes later, the farmer comes back into town with a frostbitten, cold and exhausted farmer who appears to have been running for a day or two.
Jesus.
And he just...
Roland, it's your call.
All right, I run over to him. I'd like to just like look him over. Like, obviously he's got frostbite, but I want to make sure nothing else is wrong with him. Just see what I can see from a natural perspective.
Right, roll insight.
Insight. Oh my god.
Oh.
You see that he is terrified out of his mind. He is in an absolute acute state of shock. He is like his mind is almost not working at the moment. He's not only exhausted, but he is also shocked and frightened.
Okay.
Any other yells which we forgot to kill?
from which direction did he run also?
He came in from the west.
Okay, so from where all the farmhouses are?
Farmhouses are to the north.
Well, yeah, where we went to look for the hidden food, that's west, right?
Yeah, you went west. Right.
Gotcha. Oh, but he came from the west, so he came from Rakeable's side.
No, he came from the west.
Yeah, he came from the west.
Okay.
He came from somewhere around here.
Okay, yeah, that's what I thought the first time.
Yeah.
Okay, in my estimation, would healing him up, help him with his shock or anything like that? Do we have any alcohol?
There's a big pile of bodies burning over there that might warm you up.
Estimating stupid stuff. Like, judging from his looks, you think that he is in dire need of some warmth, some supper, and maybe a large fire.
Okay. Yeah. So, is there any place with fire besides the burial ground? I don't know if that's the best thing for this guy right now. Just sit by a bunch of burning bodies. Do we have in the longhouse or in the big house? Is there fire in there?
Yeah, there's always fire running in the.
Okay, so I lead him in there. And do we have any guys? Do we have any food or something like that so we can help this guy out?
There's
I assume it's also in that room.
In Oiden, stocked up.
All right, so I set him up in front of the fire. I get him food from the longhouse. I just say, just relax. I say, you're safe right here. We've got a lot of warriors here to protect you. Just sit by the fire.
When you go into the supply room, you see that there are a couple of farmers who are working on some cart that they've loaded up with at least half of all the supplies that are stocked in Oiden.
Okay. For now, I don't pay them any attention. I just get whatever I need to help this guy out. Actually, you know what? As I'm walking away from them, I turn around. I say, do you guys know this man?
The two who are in the supply room, they say, maybe. I think that could be some of Fredrickson's family. You should talk to him about it.
Well, he's in a bit of a state right now. I was hoping I could get some more information. Nothing else had been going on before you guys came here, right? Nothing unusual besides preparing for the battle?
Oh.
All right. I take the food and I set it up for this guy.
But as you were about to leave, they say, well, actually, we've been away from our farms for quite a while now.
Where?
Maybe if something would have happened, we wouldn't necessarily know about it.
Where have you been?
Hunting you.
Oh, I see. All right, well, this guy's in a state. I'm going to take care of him. I'm going to try to figure out what's going on. There might be something going on back at your home, then, because he came sprinting from that direction.
Not from my home. I don't live with this guy.
Well, I think what we're figuring out is what affects some of us tends to affect more than just that person.
They continue just hauling some food up on the cart.
All right. Is Fredrickson eating?
Fredrickson is in the longhouse and he's doing the best he can, helping his relative. The guy who came running.
Okay, so they're somehow related. Or they're family members from the same farm. One of them's frostbitten, completely a mess, and the other one is fine. He saw him coming, basically, and picked him up. Do I understand all that correctly?
I don't understand your question.
There's two people in there, right?
Yeah. Well, there are more. Like, there's a small flock of people who are interested to hear what this guy has to say.
Okay, but who was the guy who approached him when they saw he was running?
Family, as he ran out of the town.
Gotcha. Okay. All right, so I'm not badgering him, I'm asking him, I'm just sort of observing him as he warms and seeing if he eats and things like that.
You're just observing?
Yep.
Right. It takes him roughly an hour as you guys tend to him and make sure that he's okay. And after 30 minutes, he shakes his head and he looks at Fredrickson and he says, I'm sorry. They're all dead. Every one of them. Fredrickson goes in a rampage and he,
what? What are you talking about? I had my whole family and my whole livestock back at the farm.
The rather old man shakes his head and says,
I'm sorry. I came there 3 days ago and everything was in ruins. There was blood everywhere.
And Fredrickson goes crazy and he hauls an axe on the wall.
Ah!
Starts to scream.
Is he swinging it at the guy or at the wall?
At the wall. He just chugged it at the wall. And he grabs Quenar, who is closest to him, and he shakes him.
Is this your doing? Is this your doing, you and your stupid Earl?
I was just here. How could I did it?
He says, ah! And he headbutts you.
Yay.
This isn't going to help anything. Let the man talk. I bend down to the older guy.
Definitely. All right, roll acrobatics.
Oh, I just did dexterity.
Oh, that's fine.
I'm not proficient, so it doesn't matter.
Let's see how he did. Do you have something hard on your head?
No, I have a wolf helmet. I wouldn't say it's hard.
he is trying to headbutt you. You dodge out of the way, but you managed to tilt your head in a way that a rather narrow piece of bone and a hard piece on the forehead hits his nose straight up, and he breaks his nose. Blood begins to pour out. And after a couple of minutes, his anger turns into sorrow. And he seems to be in the shock now. He's trying to process that this man says that his family and his whole farm is gone.
I just shake my head and go over to the supplies and call Ulf together to go with me.
And I go to the old guy and I'm bent on one knee and I say, first I need your name.
The messenger or the bleeding guy?
The old guy who's frostbitten and stuff.
Oh, his name?
Yep.
He says that his name is Rudolf.
All right, and Rudolf, I need you to be specific. I need you to try and be calm, and I need you to tell me everything you saw.
After roughly 10 seconds shivering, and you can see him trying to bolster some courage, he says, it was the giants, the ogres. They came in, and they wrecked everything. Of this, I'm sure.
Did you see them?
The ogres. Of course it was the ogres. They're always pillaging our lands.
Answer my question. Did you see an ogre or a giant?
I didn't see the ogre, but the farm was in ruins. No one could have done that but the ogres.
From what direction do these ogres come from? Where do they live?
Fredrickson has been around for many years. I believe he has better knowledge of that than I do, but somewhere around Sweden Wilds, between our lands and Sweden Wilds, that's where they live.
Okay.
Swampy and hilly areas.
Fredrickson, come here. I gesture him over towards me.
Just like 1 meter next to him, holding his nose, and he looks at you.
I reach over and I touch his shoulder. And I cast Cure Wounds.
And all of a sudden, his nose, the blood dries up, and he's like,
whoa! By Odin's boss, thank you. How did you do this?
It's not important right now. I need you to listen. Where do those giants and ogres come from? Is this something you've ever heard of before?
Filthy ogres. They take my livestock. Eat it, and they eat humans like candy.
Rudolf here says that they come from east of your lands. Is that true? In between here and the wilds?
It's been many years since I saw an ogre, but somewhere I think I can find them if given enough time.
But they're definitely capable of destroying farms.
Oh yeah. They're 10 to 15 feet tall and their arms are the size of two men.
And are they intelligent? Do they speak? Do they just destroy?
Ogres.
Yeah.
They're not intelligent. They're stupid and they're filthy.
I understand that you hate them, but this is important. If we're going to stop them, we need to know everything we can about them. Why do they come to your farms? Is it simply they need food?
I was here fighting you. Do you think I know why they came there?
Not this time, I mean in general. Have you guys ever had a reason that you thought that they came to your lands besides just you had food and they wanted it? Was it that simple?
He seems to be absolutely puzzled by your question. He says, he looks around at the other Vikings, farmers. He says, do you understand what this guy is asking me about? They're ogres.
I look at the group as well for help and seeing if anybody else can answer my question. I say, can anybody think of a motive for an ogre?
They all look rather complex and they just look at you and they're like, what is he talking about? What's he aiming up for?
All right. Say, so, well, I'm afraid if they attach one farm, it's possible that they could be moving to others, and it's something we're going to have to take care of. So we're going to need to meet up again so that we can decide who's going to go there and who's going to help us find these ogres. I'm going to stand up and go look for... I know Ulf and Kvenar and Sigmar are here. I'm going to go make sure... I'm going to go look for the dwarf and... Or Goldwick, I just call you the dwarf. I'm gonna go look for Goldwick and see where he's at.
To be fair, I never actually think Goldwick mentioned his name.
It's fair, the dwarf then.
Yeah.
Yeah. I went with Ulf to get some supplies. Did those guys stop us? I went with Ulf to the supply room to get some supplies because we definitely are going to go somewhere.
When you say that you're gonna go, the Viking leader of the farmers stands up and says, oh no, you're not getting away this easy. Yesterday we agreed that you guys are to stay here and train us. Those were the terms.
I never heard those terms, and one of your farms got pillaged. Don't you want to know what happened to it?
We'll go. We'll investigate it.
With all due respect... I guess I'm not there.
Yeah. I just shrug and say, okay, sure, enjoy. And go away.
You were there, Roland.
Oh, okay. I wasn't sure if I had left the longhouse yet. With all due respect, sir, I don't know how long you'll last out there. You saw what Ulf did to your other man. From what I hear, these ogres are much worse. By all means, we can help each other to accomplish this, but we're not your captives.
Be that as it may, I do not trust you yet.
We don't have to trust each other.
Farms, I'm gonna have to send someone with you. Cast look against Lytar. He says, you there.
Yes.
Do you mind keeping an eye on these rascals for me? I do not trust them.
Well, I'm not a babysitter.
I didn't tell you to babysit. But it seems as if these men are without honor, so I'm asking you if you could keep an eye out for my men and for my farm.
They don't seem to like me as much. I don't know how good of an idea this is.
Lytar, right?
Hello, did you hear me?
Yeah.
Yeah, I heard you.
All right.
Lytar, I know we don't know each other yet, but it seems that there are some people who cannot defend themselves who are under attack to the west. I think it's going to help everybody out if we can go there. And it seems like you can handle yourself pretty well. So even if we don't trust each other, even if we don't know each other, I think it might be in everybody's best interest if we did this.
Look, I don't mind helping people that need to be helped, but I don't think it's a good idea to put me in some kind of weird guardian role while I barely know you.
Sure, go alone and die there alone. Sure. Let's go together, at least. This way I know you are not a bear, at least, and don't shoot you when you are a bear.
I wasn't opposed to joining. I'm just saying that I don't like being put in a guardian role.
All you need to do is...
Targo, he intervenes and he says, fine, I'll send a couple of men with you. Fredrickson, bring at least two guys. Make sure to be back here within the week. The Viking leaves the room and goes back to the pyre. Fredrickson and the old man, they are still in the longhouse.
Are there lots of Vikings still here and farmers?
There are some.
Okay.
Would Sigma know where, like, the armory is? Like, where the remaining weapons were and or are kept? Probably, yes, at this point.
I was thinking that yesterday, Sigma.
I don't think you know it, but...
Well, I can ask. So,
yeah.
That's the second point. Like, I wouldn't go ask if I wouldn't know already. But I assume I have an assumption, at least. Or is it just a secret? I mean, we went there and got, like, the bow for Quenna.
What?
The huskarls have their own smaller longhouse. That seems to be a place where they have weapons. But you haven't seen actual armory.
Yeah, Sigma's just gonna make his way there. He's a curious sort anyway. So he's just... When like the dialogue has pretty much ceased, he's just gonna jump over the large chair thing, and he has of course finished his late breakfast, and he's gonna put his hands in his pocket and walk there.
Right. Is anyone accompanying him?
I'll go with him.
Yeah, I guess I'll also go with him.
Where does he go to?
Longhouse for the huskarls.
All right.
Not going to be anybody there.
Entering this longhouse, you see that some of the farmers indeed have already found this place, and they have slept in there, made it their temporary home. But one guy wakes up as you guys open the door, and he says,
oh, you, what are you doing in here? Why aren't you at the pyre?
Sigma's making an inspection. Why are you not at pyre?
Because I got badly wounded yesterday. I needed to rest.
And he shows you he has bandages all over his body. And he says, hey, you! You're the guy who bandaged me. I need to thank you.
So, yeah, you're welcome. How's it going today?
I says it hurts, but my friends say that thanks to you, I'm alive. Is good. There any way I can repay the favor?
Help Sigmar look through this stuff in here that used to belong to the other huskarls. I think then we'll be even.
He says, as long as you don't touch the weapons that my friends have tucked away under the beds, you're all free to look around.
I put my hand out for Sigmar. Go for it.
And yeah, Sigmar would just start looking
back to a door behind him. Seems to be a small room at the end of the longhouse.
Yeah, Sigma's just gonna look through stuff, like, pretty much, like, to get an overview of, like, what they have. I mean, on one hand, for his own armory, but also to arm the peasants later.
Seems to be a couple of spears, javelins, short bows, axes, larger axes, and leather armors, as well as some shields and ammunition.
Oh yeah, by the way, how many arrows did I get? Because while I was short resting, I told you, like, I'm restocking on arrows, but you never told me to roll anything.
Oh.
I like the distinction between axes and large axes.
So this is a man's axe.
Where did you look for arrows?
It's a guard tower.
The guard, as many as you'd like. They had stocked away hundreds of arrows there, as well as quivers. Alright, so what do you guys do in the room? Supply room, or whatever.
I would be totally interested in seeing if any of the other shields are lighter than mine, but like still seem like really good quality.
If not, that's fine. One rather small brass shield that seems to be a lot lighter. But it does look a lot smaller.
Yeah, I'm looking through the bows just to see if any are fancy and unusual in some way.
Can I estimate how much it weighs, too?
It seems to be lifting it up. It seems to be exceptionally light. No more than 1.5 pounds.
Are there any long bows or studded leather armors?
No.
Goddamn Vikings.
Okay.
There are short bows only. And just like regular leather armor, like not even fancy. Just some.
I already have that Pokemon.
So bows are just common bows, right?
Yep.
Okay. I'm not interested.
So, in here, there's something else than weapons. Like, is this the house? I assume this is the house card, long haul. So, is there anything else? Chests, stuff like that.
In the room you're in now, there seems to be a room that was once rather stocked with items, but right now what is left is just like piles of weapons and axes, and none of them seem to be rather fancy, except for the brass shield that maybe someone has forgotten or something.
Can I roll an insight to get an idea of where the stuff went?
You being yourself, don't even need to roll insight. Walking in in the longhouse, you saw that under the beds of the farmers there were quite a deal of stuff stashed away.
Oh yeah, then is Ulf with us?
He stayed at Longhouse, attending to the crazed man.
Yeah, well, problem is Sigma's kind of stuck with other stuff, so if he finds something, he technically can't carry it away. So why fight or discuss with farmers now when he can't actually carry stuff?
Well, that's hindsight.
Yeah.
Anybody of you guys can carry stuff?
I'm pushing it right now. That's why I'm looking for a different shield and stuff.
Hmm.
Well,
I just shrug. I can carry that shield, but why would I?
Yeah, probably not much sense.
I'll pick it up and put mine down. Maybe just check it out for a while.
Where'd that Galdwick guy go?
He's probably at his forge.
He's probably robbing the corpses blind outside. Who knows?
Where are you, Galdwick? Are you with him?
I don't know. I'll probably
I feel like that's a cue that you have to walk in the door.
I guess it would have been like seeing if I could find metal and just like smithing, because gotta make some money.
That you do.
All right. So right about now, you managed to get the forge going, as it takes a while to get it heated. And as far as metal goes, you still had the fine spatula you crafted.
Yeah, that one. Yeah. One lovely spatula.
Plus one to cook.
Sell it to farmers, they don't know better.
I will try to like reforge my spatula into something proper.
What is something proper?
I guess like a sword. Yeah, I'll make the spatula to a sword.
Right. Go ahead and roll me.
Play like a spatula.
Alright, you managed to forge the hilt. Now you have to go to forge the blade.
A roll more?
Yeah. You managed to create a fine short sword. This, however, will take you a couple of hours.
Oh yeah.
So while this is evolving, you're hammering away your spatula.
Well, anyway, we kinda need to set some rules, I think. Sigma pretty sure that this is not the way we can make this work. Like, if everybody takes everything, we're probably gonna sit with nothing, like, next week. So...
Well, if you talk to them.
How many farmers are there?
Where?
In the huskarls hall. In the huskarls hall.
Only the one guy who's resting.
Oh, there's just the one guy?
Currently, yeah.
Does he look still quite hurt?
Yeah.
Great.
Oh, God damn it, Sigmar.
Okay, you probably...
No, it's not in character, like, I know what you're going to do.
Does he have more than 26 HP?
He seems to be sound asleep.
God. Fine, then Sigma starts searching everything else.
I just shake my head and go to the archery range, and Roland, when you are ready to move, just call me. I'll be training. I don't want to be a part of this.
How do the rest of you guys react?
Why?
Was that a question for me?
No, why did he cast sleep? That's what I asked him.
Man look tired, need sleep. Also probably get in the way.
Little too proactive, don't you think?
Well, what did you imagine? He clearly mentioned we not look at stuff. And so alternatives are we don't look at stuff, which is not feasible because we need to know what we have. We can discuss it out, which probably leads to him calling other farmers in, which leads to trouble. Or we can hope that we can somehow persuade him, which takes A, time, and B, risk. So Sigma was pretty sure this was the right thing to do. Well, actually, Sigma didn't even think about it, was so sure for a press second. More like, you know, a cupping.
TikTok.
Usually when I want something from someone, I don't cast a spell. I just talk about it. And if I don't get the desired answer, then obviously that's something that needs to be worked out. That's not a reason to start attacking someone.
Didn't attack anybody. Man was tired. Well,
some would classify, even if it's a non-lethal spell, you still attacked him.
No.
Man, well, I'm telling you, some people would see that as hostility.
Yeah, well, considering the fact that man was really tired, he would probably consider it sleep.
Light on all his eyes.
Also, Sigma doesn't really care.
Am I talking to... Is Sigma referring to himself in the third person?
Oh yeah, he always does that. You gotta get used to that pretty fast. I also mirrored his eye roll, but I am still in here with them.
Lighter just... He's gonna do something else. He's just gonna walk out.
Right. This conversation took you guys roughly 30-ish seconds. Glancing around the room, you see that five beds on top of the bed where the guy is sleeping seem to be stuffed with some various stuff underneath them.
What kind of injuries does he have?
He has some slash wound on his upper torso, but he is bandaged, so he's healing.
Does he have any kind of head wounds?
No.
Well, that might actually change soon. Is there some kind of club or any blunt weapon lying around?
There's a candlestick on the table.
Like, is it no? Like, how does it look? Is it a blunt weapon? Like, is it? It's like, I'm looking for something.
A candlestick.
I'm looking for something that a professional would use to knock somebody out.
Professional.
Yeah, yes. Well, the level of professionality that Sigma is on. He has some experience with knocking people out at this point. Okay, never mind. I just
grab the candlestick if you're like I said.
Yeah, that's probably the thing Sigma will do.
Alright. Roland, you see how Sigmar goes up on the table, grabs the candlestick, walks over to the farmer who is sound asleep, and roll attack with advantage.
No, I think he's asleep, so it's an automatic crit.
Still have to hit?
I doubt that I have to hit, but I will still roll it.
How about if you...
You have to hit, and if you hit, it's an automatic crit. Look it up, fool.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you seem to be right, actually. It is hitting.
Sigmar, what are you doing?
Come. Hit him over the head. Roll additional d4.
Well, I don't know what a candlestick does, but...
And sneak attack damage.
Oh, yeah.
And crit sneak attack damage. You did say non-lethal, right?
Yeah, I did say I want to knock him out.
It's going to be enough damage to knock him out. Let's just leave it at that.
Oh, my God.
Okay, he's definitely out.
Roland, you
Sigmar.
Lifting his arm up and dunk! A large, a loud thud. Dunk.
Why did you put him to sleep if you're gonna break his head in? I run over
his jaw.
Oh my
gets a bit dislodged, and you see him starting to drool, and you hear this sound.
You're lucky that fucking Lytar left, dude. This is like the opening scene of fucking Dead Saints 7.
That's so funny.
You asked why Sigma first put his sleep, then hit him with candlestick?
Yes, yeah. that was my question, in that order.
Wow. Easier to hit?
Jesus, what? Just do whatever you came here to do so I can heal this guy.
Fine, and Sigma starts rummaging through the stuff. And, like, cataloging what he finds in his mind to get an impression of what he has to actually stuff
out.
You're
gonna catalog everything in the room?
No, like, try to memorize what he finds.
Oh, just going through it fast and...
Yeah.
There seems to be some coinage stuffed away in each of the piles, some weapons, some food, and...
Yeah, well, a bit more precise about the interesting stuff would be nice. Like, I want to make a decision if I want to keep anything, and if not, who gets what.
After you spend a couple of minutes looking through all of the stuff, the door goes up, boom, and four guys walk in, and they say, "What the fuck are you doing? And what did you do to him?" They see him laying there, still drooling.
Well, he's knocked out. How can he still be making a noise?
They walk towards you with a hostile attitude.
I probably have noticed that. At least the fact that they were approaching, as it's absolutely silent. So I'd probably not be surprised.
You're in the fucking house. You don't hear what happens outside. I'm sorry.
But I hear, like, the door, don't I? Like,
well, yeah.
The door
that's
opening
what I'm saying.
Or something
you
like
the
that.
Door go up and they talk to you.
Oh, well, have I finished rummaging through the stuff or am I still about to do
it? No, that was mid-process. You were going through a lot of stuff.
Oh, yeah. And, well, Sigma turns around and, well, Sigma's making catalog of items.
I say, the last time we saw our friend here, he was doing fine. Now we walk in and they walk over to him and they inspect his head and they say, "You hit him."
Yeah,
what kind
actually,
of monster are you?
Actually, with candlestick.
Monster
is just out, not even badly hurt, just out, no problem.
They walk angry towards you. And it is clear on their body language that they.
I say, wait, just watch. And I put my hand on the guy and I clearly and audibly cast Cure Wounds, like making sure to be extra dramatic about it.
And his dent on his head seemed to withdraw. He looks up and sees four of his friends staring at him, rather angry. He sees Sigmar and Roland, and he goes like, "What are you guys doing? What's going on?"
My impulsive friend here decided he should catalog all of the inventory in this room. He knocked you unconscious, and I just healed you. I'm sorry about that.
And he says, "Hey, I told you not to touch the stuff of my friends."
Yeah, and
that
I decided
the term you agreed to.
There were no agreement. You said something which you weren't allowed to because it's not your stuff, and I decided to not discuss it at this point.
Like I said, impulsive.
And two of the guys tries to grab Sigmar from behind. But you manage to wriggle yourself loose and sprint away a good 2 yards before they get a chance to react.
It's actually a 21. The advantage doesn't change it.
Yeah. I already told you what's gonna happen.
Why? Why must you farmers always take what isn't yours and then get aggressive? Sigma's just avoiding him. It's probably pretty decent avoidance. Okay, so, guys, calm down. Last guy that made Sigma angry was Yarl, and you know how Yarl ended. Now, calm down!
Roll intimidation with advantage.
I'm still horrible at intimidation. No, it's actually decent.
Whoa.
They say, fine, well, fine, alright, alright. We get your point. But this stuff is ours, okay? If you want something, you go look elsewhere.
How to is be exactly fair, yeah. That it came to be yours?
As you're saying this, one of the guys is slowly but steadily walking towards the door.
Would you kindly answer my question?
You say that we won the fight, and so we get to loot. Simple as that.
That's actually not how it works. Actually, loot is split among the winners. Not everybody takes what he can grab. I'm pretty sure about that.
What communist halfling village are you from? Because they clearly have communists in this age.
Okay, guys, we really need to talk this out. Now that you have apparently, through some odd circumstance, arrived just in time and not stayed for 5 minutes longer at the fire, we really need to talk about how we split loot in this village. Because if you take all the stuff that is worth anything, and, well, you know, if the principle is everybody takes what he can get, then there's the principle, one barbarian and one pretty badass dwarf get everything.
They look kind of nervous, and they look at each other, and they say, what do you suggest?
Well, what Sigma tried to do, we catalog things and split them up, vote about it, you know, we agreed on voting for important decisions in the longhouse last evening, anything picking.
They say, no, you're not getting our stuff. This is
okay,
ours.
Fine. Sigma's just gonna tell the rest of the village. Let's see how they think about it.
And Sigma's just getting increasingly frustrated by this whole affair, like how it played out, and how they are so stubborn and only trying to get did he actually find on the some minutes that he was able to rummage through the stuff? Like, did he get the impression to make it maybe a bit quicker? Did he get the impression that they really stowed away the best stuff for themselves, or did they randomly collect
stuff? Valuable stuff, but most were the regular stuff like weapons and ammunition, food. The stuff of any value that you saw were like trinkets and liquor.
Okay, but there was like
some coins.
Nothing, yeah. Nothing. In the time he rummaged through the stuff, there was nothing outstanding quality or price, like probably chain shirts, better made long swords, something like that.
No. They were all tossed on the pyre with the warriors, their weapons and armor.
Okay, so it's more or less like from what Sigma knows, we're talking about medium stuff and some trinkets.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. I'm not gonna use the F word, but
You're not what I'm thinking. And Sigma's just gonna hands in his pocket and walk out.
They glare at you guys as you walk out.
Okay, good. I was gonna say I'm awkwardly sitting next to the guy at his heel. I will awkwardly like, I guess my friend really does mean the best for you guys. He just has a weird way of doing things, and I walk out after him.
Do you guys walk back to the longhouse?
Sure.
Where are you, Lidar?
I just was just tired of that whole situation, so I just walked out in anger, kind of suppressed anger, and I don't know. I just, it's just kind of like going for like a walk to cool down, you know?
Yeah. All right. So you see Lidar pacing in the center of the town. When you get out, the guy who sneaked out before you, he has already made his way to the longhouse. You see him just entering the longhouse. You see Kranar a couple of yards away, shooting at the archery range.
Well, Roland, wanna make a bet?
On what?
On how many hours will it take until we kill the next peasant? Like, the whole situation for Sigma, it's always the same. You come to a place, you try to be nice to people, they get oddly angry and believe that trying everything to becomes be nice. To them.
Bash in their heads and steal from them.
Well,
technically it was extremely unlucky. Like, the timing was extremely unlucky. It was a decent plan.
I have to say, I'm not sure where you're from, Sigmar, but smacking someone over the head with a candlestick wouldn't go over too well where I'm from.
Well, as I explained before, there were like two alternatives. We could look through the stuff, get through it, have no discussion, heal the guy up or bandage him, he wakes up, everybody's fine, he doesn't know what happens. There was a slight chance, a tiny chance, that his friends come in the next 10 minutes with the pyre burning and everybody singing sad songs. But in exactly those 10 minutes that Sigma would have needed to make a decent list of all the items we have, which, by the way, we promised to use to stuff up the peasants with. So Sigma was even technically right, because it's stuff that we agreed we would use to arm the peasants that they can defend themselves and not like use to make some peasants rich. So everything could have worked out so fine. Just, you know, he wakes up, he has a bit of a bad head, but doesn't really know what happened. Stuff is going fine.
Sigmar, so, sometimes...
Risk-reward was probably decent.
Sometimes I'm afraid you mistake good intentions and good actions, my friend.
No, was good action. Did you see what his head did?
It was good certainly action. It was a terrifying swing, if that's what you're referring to.
Yeah, terrifying.
Then you hear it. Cling, cling, cling. A couple of, like 30 yards away, you see a Gulbik smashing away at a forge.
Should we gather everybody who's going on this trip?
Why exactly do we go on trip?
I feel like if we don't stop whatever's destroying the farms, there's not going to be much to protect or build a village around in Hoyden anyway.
So, why we not make for Reykjavik? Apparently every farmer around here gives a shit about us.
Only when you hit them with candlesticks.
You see the Viking leader and a couple of guys, including Ericsson, walking out of the longhouse with their weapons drawn. they approach you. The Viking leader immediately says,
Sigma bets 5 minutes.
He says, well, why aren't I surprised? So, you guys told me that I could trust you, and this is what you do?
Who does what? Town.
What was the last thing he said? It was sort of muffled.
Yeah, I didn't get it also.
In the middle of town.
In the middle of town?
Yeah.
Middle of town what?
If you're trying to deceive me, you surely didn't even try to do a good job. You're saying that you're honorable and that I should trust you and let you guys off. And 10 minutes after, I hear that you bash one of my guy's heads in while he's sleeping, trying to rob him.
Nobody robbed anybody. Nothing was taken, you know? Idea when robbing is you knock out guy, take stuff and run. What Sigma did was knock out guy, count stuff, which apparently belongs to village and not to guy, because we agreed on it in council.
Yes, kind of face-palming. Ugh. You're always talking, aren't you?
Yeah, of course, Sigma always talking. We agree on stuff, and then everybody does what he thinks is good. We agreed that weapons were used to arm the guys and to train them. And first thing your guys do is get everything that is expensive, stuff it in their pockets and under their beds, and then tell Sigma that he's not allowed to go through it. I mean, what idea would I get? Who got stuff that he wasn't disturbing? Who didn't tell anybody what he was taking? Sigma still has the same stuff than yesterday in battle, while your guys took everything that was of worth from the house cards and then told us bravely that it was all belonging to them, even though we agreed otherwise, like 10 hours before in the longhouse all together. So where exactly is Sigma's mistake but in knocking out a person and trying to get what he had a right to anyway, which even was healed afterwards, magically. So there was no damage done to your people, no damage done to farmers, no damage done to anybody but to Sigma and his friends, who didn't get any share of what was agreed to be split and used for the good of the village.
He says that he has no idea what you're talking about. And why do you even think that you deserve to get any kind of reward after what you did?
Because it was agreed on to use stuff for village and not for singular farmers in the longhouse yesterday evening.
Yes, and the town will remain and you will have your claim for it.
Sigma's just... At this point, he's just not even trying anymore. He's just gonna shake his head, resign, and okay, fine, we find August. How much worse can it be?
What did you say?
Okay, fine, we just go find August. How much worse can it be? Sigma's just shaking his head. He's just not getting anything anymore.
He says, after your last shenanigans, what we're gonna do is one of you guys are gonna have to remain here in Oiden. And if it is coinage you're after, halfling, I'm sure that we can find a way to reward you. But you have to understand, if I hear that you're bashing the heads in of my guys,
there was no bashing head in, he was alive, he was just knocked out. That's a difference.
Bold. Bold, bold, bold.
Sigma's just not getting it. At this point, he's just not understanding anything. Like, he was pretty sure about the agreement that they had, like using stuff for village and equipping villagers, and what he did was basically like some kind of odd self-help that he justified, but he's just not really getting it. But he's agreeing probably to everything because he's just fatalistic at this point.
Okay. he instructs two of his men to take an archer or two with them and accompany you guys to investigate the farm. Fredrickson immediately says that he's gonna get to the bottom of this and slay every ogre. If it so is the last thing that he will ever do.
Misclick? I didn't mean to click that button. I think I whispered to someone. I don't know what I did.
Whispered?
What? I don't know. I did something.
Okay. Well, I can't see it.
Never mind it then. I don't know. Apparently I whispered to myself.
That's Ulf's job.
That's useful.
Alright, let's gather everybody and get going on this. You know, each day just keeps getting better.
Hello,
well, that was extreme bad luck.
Actions, and you blame the world.
Yeah.
And, alright, after a couple of minutes, you guys managed to group up your group of misfits, and you seem to be ready to head out. The dwarf just finishing up his weapons, the druid just reluctantly tagging along, Quenar shooting arrows until the last second, Sigmar
and also checking if we have food with us.
There's plenty of food, you can just stock up if you need some.
Well, how many people are going?
Ulf is gonna stay behind.
Okay, what about Johan? Is he staying or is he going?
As you ask that, he just like cast you a look as if he's super worried. Like, I'm going, where are you going?
So, Johan, these people might need you to help start training them. You are one of our archers, after all. But if you're insistent, by all means.
So how many farmers are going with us?
Seems to be 3 farmers who tag along.
Is one of them is the guy from the farm which got destroyed, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I want to go next to him and ask him, how far is the farm which we are going to? We need to prepare food, to take food with us.
He says that it's roughly 1 or 2 miles of trekking before you will reach her.
Oh, so it's 1 day trip, right?
1 or 2 days.
That'll be a lot of food again.
Hmm.